Here's something that I just stumbled across in Wikipedia while I was looking for something entirely non-related. This is about Neolithic Britain, the period of domestication of plants and animals. Pollen analysis shows that woodland was decreasing and grassland increasing, with a major decline of elms. The winters were typically 3 degrees colder than at present, but the summers some 2.5 degrees warmer. Okay, so was it warmer or colder than today? Does it have a temperature at all? If the winters are 3 degrees colder and the summers are 2.5 degrees warmer, the average temperature really hasn't changed. But the climate has changed in ways that matter to animals, plants, and people. And that's just Britain. What about the entire globe? In fact, it's not even clear that the Earth has a temperature in the same sense that a sick kid or a cup of tea has one. If parts of it are warming and others are cooling in complex patterns, it may only tell us that assigning an average temperature to the Earth makes about as much sense as saying that a man with a sunburned head and frostbitten feet is comfortable overall. And if, for instance, Arctic ice is shrinking, but Antarctic ice is growing, it may only tell us that the Earth as a whole doesn't have a climate. It's far too complex for that. And the insights of chaos theory penetrated a certain distance into popular culture. There's a Dilbert cartoon where he says,
"I know that my computer model is accurate, but nobody believes me when I predict that squirrels will conquer the Earth." And the garbage man replies, "Of course you're aware that according to chaos theory, any complex iterative model is no better than a wild guess, even if the logic is perfect." And Dilbert says, "You're making that up," which the garbage man replies, "You caught me. I'm really a giant spy squirrel in disguise." In fact, the garbage man is not making it up. James Gleick himself says, "Only a few scientists understood how nonlinear nature is in its soul." Enrico Fermi once exclaimed, "It does not say in the Bible that all laws of nature are expressed linearly." And the mathematician Stanislaw Ulam once remarked that to call the study of chaos nonlinear science was like calling zoology the study of non-elephant animals. But not everybody gets this. Al Gore certainly doesn't know it.
They tell us, the scientists do, that the Earth's climate is a nonlinear system, just a fancy way they have of saying that the changes are not all just gradual. Some of them come suddenly in big jumps.
He thinks it means a predictable effect will come with unpredictable timing and intensity, but it doesn't mean that at all. It means that very small changes in the inputs, sometimes too small to be measured, mean the effect will not merely have a different magnitude than you're expecting, but will be in a different direction. Stephen Hawking once said, "While physics and mathematics may tell us how the universe began, they're not much use in predicting human behavior because there are far too many equations to solve. I'm no better than anyone else at understanding what makes people tick, particularly women." Thank goodness, in a way, right? Dating's not an equation. If it were, there's always the danger that you'd come out as zero. But Hawking just says that there are too many equations to solve. And in fact, the problem goes a lot deeper than that. So come back to Wikipedia's statement that causes of ice ages are not fully understood. We are trying to model things using linear algebra that cannot be modeled using linear algebra, because we would need to know the precise details. The model would in fact need to have so much detail in it that it wouldn't be a model, it would be the original reality. And again, this is very disturbing because it tells us that we don't know things that we need to know. Many people resist this insight in the modern world because they're still convinced that, in Galileo's words, mathematics is the language in which God has written the universe. And so they persist in trying to model things even though the models don't work. We can't even predict rogue waves, and yet we're trying to predict what the climate is going to be like in 200 years. And we're using models that can't explain what it's been like for the last 200 or the last 12,000.